Hey everyone, welcome to KNews 24/7. My name is Cameron. I have Upis, my co-host. We are discussing everything that is happening at Naturena. All right, Mganam?
Kahle kakhulu bafo, all right, wena?
No, ngimnandi too much.
Uh-huh.
There's something about Kaizer Chiefs. Let's start with this story about Asanele Velebhai. In previous month, we found a report stating that Kaizer Chiefs are interested in this Cape Town Spurs player. They submitted an offer, but Cape Town Spurs rejected that offer.
Yeah.
But Kaizer Chiefs kept on pushing. According to previous reports, Kaizer Chiefs kept on pushing until they approached the player's parents, who is Asanele Velebhai. They also approached the player himself. And Cape Town Spurs was not happy about all this. Their CEO reported saying, no, all this is true, and they are too disappointed to Kaizer Chiefs for doing all this. But today, early, Kaizer Motaung Jr., they say he was on Radio 2000. I also saw other clips from News Africa. They say, according to Kaizer Motaung Jr., he states that Kaizer Chiefs never went to Velebhai's parents and they never approached Asanele Velebhai. So now, I don't understand who is telling the truth between Kaizer Motaung Jr. and Cape Town Spurs CEO.
Yeah.
I trust the CEO and I trust Kaizer Motaung Jr. So now I don't know.
Yeah, it's two contradicting stories. I was Tatisip. But I think the deal yokuthi ihlapi be involved or involve ama parents of player akusinto it's not a new thing. Into siyazi ukuthi it's been happening over the years, you know. Ayiqali manje since ba reportile ngo Velebhai. So obviously it deal didn't happen. So I think to protect reputation and brand, Kaizer Chiefs, angeka vele keep a statement with sizamile sase safika nabazali bakhe kwalili, you know. You have to be professional. So obviously we can't say it didn't happen because it has happened before, you know. So yeah, I also don't think ukuthi CEO Cape Town Spurs can, you know, just go into the media and say stuff like that. Obviously, besekabona na ukuthi pressure is even coming from the parents. Ukuthi mhlambe khona lo nandahloko lozayo. So, yeah, that's just how I see it.
Mele sibahlalise phansi boy two.
Yeah, yabona kanjalo.
Basichazele. Bayiqeda indaba yabo, solithola iqiniso.
Ingaphuma because iyo biphuma from both sources sesiyobona lapho ukuthi kahle ubani losishayashaya.
Eh, ndoda, but asiphume lapho because Asanele Velebhai move to Kaizer Chiefs failed.
Yeah.
It won't happen. Yeah. So I don't know ukuthi it's only Velebhai's move only now. Because it looks like but CEO Cape Town Spurs says ukuthi no, he's not fighting with the Kaizer Chiefs. Everything is well. He just not happy about how Kaizer Chiefs did in terms of this Velebhai deal.
Yeah.
So, but it mustn't rule it up. These are sad news.
Aish.
Bad news, not sad, because sad news, I'm arresting peace. But these are bad news. Fernando de Cruz.
Yeah.
Fernando de Cruz left Kaizer Chiefs with immediate effect. He's going back to Morocco. So he was Kaizer Chiefs' second assistant coach. The last time I've checked, he was also a technical director of the Kaizer Chiefs.
Yeah.
Now he is gone with immediate effect. He's going to Morocco.
It seems like it's just predicted these things because you said Kaizer Chiefs are not a technical director. And look now, Vela senile.
So,
we are always forward. But yeah, man. It's a bad loss for Kaizer Chiefs, but nakona I think it has been coming for a long time because the reporter before Gucci was it Fusrapat? Yeah. It was a team from
Lanitini na Umiki. He's telling lies.
That's mean. I mean, Umiki again. I support his work, you know. Yeah. So, but yeah, some of the children were really
yeah, calling Miki a fake journalist.
Yeah.
So we don't know, but Lana abamishinanga ukuthi he as far about or in club yakhon. They just said a club from Morocco.
Didn't I think it's the Morocco national team.
Morocco national team.
Yes, straight, because the way by reporting a corner, obviously, you can say no to Fus Rabat, but in Morocco, yeah, but Morocco is very big now.
Internationally.
So, yeah, internationally. They were on the semi-finals of the World Cup, and Nali Ntwana Zabe Zingani, they performed well Guma Olympics recently. So Yabo Maso Yubambi is Kunda School as a technical director. Yeah, it's your improved CV. For me, I think he's very, very highly qualified, which
he can coach anywhere.
Exactly.
So I think as the Kaizer Chiefs, were lucky, fortunate to have both of them.
Yeah.
Nabi and also Fernando de Cruz, because Fernando de Cruz himself without Nabi, he can run the club.
Exactly. Yeah, so, Yona, it's a loss, but it's not much of a loss because Tina Vele Sasfunu Nabi from the start, you know. Mm-hmm. And then yeah, now who's in the technical team like Kulonga to say yeah, Kuluga and Nanji
before Kaizer Chiefs now. Because we had how many were they? Five?
I think five.
And then the analyst I zanga ya feel.
Yeah.
Mm. Analyst bete tole and offer le go golf.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm. Now sigaya hambo muni. Like what's going on?
Yeah, you know, it's but I don't know, but man. But I just think
is it possible if you've signed the contract?
Yeah.
Pela maso we sign the contract. It's something else. Magne signature.
Yeah, exactly.
You agreed. So it doesn't matter ukuthi yipi ofezayo kwenzakalani. As long as you have agreed.
But yeah, uvumile, yes, at that time isn't busy grand. But I think you can break the contract. Because this is in Nigeria, first of all. And you know, mhlambi club na yabona ukuthi okay. You are the one who's saying I'm leaving, I'm going to Morocco. They tabled a better offer, so the club doesn't have to pay you with sick release or anything. Sick release, imagine, and then
because he left with just immediate effect.
Yeah, so yeah, financially it's a good decision. Yeah, you are not very, because we would like to have to see you with Uspatilini in that assistant coach role, as well as technical department. I mean,
technical director.
Yes, technical director. So, because I am 40, njengoba besisho before, it seems like we have lost our identity and we needed someone to bring back something that we lost. So,
okay.